ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 8th பாசுரம். கீழ்வானம் வெள்ளென்று எருமை சிறுவீடு, மேய்வான் பரந்தன காண்மிக்குள்ள பிள்ளைகளும், போவான் போகின்றாரை போகாமல் காத்து, உன்னை கூவான் வந்து நின்றோம் கோதுகலமுடைய, பாவாய் எழுந்திராய் பாடிப்பறை கொண்டு, மாவாய் பிளந்தானை மல்லரை மாட்டிய, தேவாதி தேவனை சென்று நாம் சேவித்தால் ஆவாவென்றாராய்ந்து அருளேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ப்ரொசீடிங் டு டூ த பாவை நோன்பு, பட் ஆண்டாள் ஃபைண்ட்ஸ் தட் சம் ஆஃப் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹாவ் நாட் யட் டேர்ன்ட் அப். நாட் வாண்டிங் டு லீவ் ஈவன் அ சிங்கிள் ஃப்ரெண்ட் பிஹைண்ட், ஆண்டாள் கோஸ் டு கால் தோஸ் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹூ ஹவ் நாட் கம். This is described in the second and the third scenes of the Thiruppavai. We saw that in the second scene, two girls have now been woken up already. So, Aandaal is proceeding to the house of the third girl today in the 8th Pasuram. Aandaal has been telling these girls about indications of dawn so that they can understand that it is time for them to get up and come and join her band. So, she was talking about indications of bird chirping in the past two pasurams. Now, it seems that time has proceeded further and the horizon has started showing indications that it is time for sunrise. Now, what happens when it is time for sunrise? Aandaal says, Keezhvaanam vellendru. The eastern horizon starts appearing whitish in color when it is time for sunrise. So, my dear friend, please look at the eastern horizon. It has started appearing whitish, so it's time for you to get up. The girl inside, this third girl, is a very learned person, it seems. She has a lot of training in the shastras and she has been listening to a lot of lectures about logic and understanding. So she says that, Aandaal and my dear other friends, I think you people are mistaken. You people seem to have something called anyatha jnanam. Now, what is this anyatha jnanam? The girls outside are all very simple. They don't know so many technical terms. So they ask the Gopika inside as to, what do you mean by anyatha jnanam? Can you please explain? The girl inside starts explaining very nicely. She says, my dear friends, anyatha jnanam means understanding something in an entirely different manner. Understanding something other than what it is intended to mean. People outside are more confused now. They are like, what do you actually mean to say? What did we tell you now? We told you that the eastern horizon has become whitish. Please come out. So how are we mistaken in this case? The girl inside replies that, see my dear friends, you people are all very enthusiastic about going and meeting Krishna, doing the Pavai Nombu and all that. So you have not been able to sleep at all. We all met last night and after meeting, you people have been constantly thinking about when to get up, when to start the nombu. So, in this extra enthusiasm, you people have got up well before time when it is midnight only. And now you all are coming as a group to my house. As you are coming, you are anticipatingly looking at the eastern horizon for sunrise. You want the sun to rise fast so that you can start your vratam as soon as possible. So, all of you are constantly looking at the eastern horizon. And you know how each one of you are like, how beautiful your faces are. Each one of you has a face like the moon. So, when so many moon-like faces are looking at the eastern horizon, the reflection of these faces is falling on that dark horizon and making it look as if there is light there. So, it is completely misunderstanding of yours that it is dawn time. Actually, There's nothing like whitishness on the eastern horizon. You people have anyatha jnanam. The girls outside are like, wow, you are such an intelligent girl. We really don't have an answer for this. We understand that you have the intellect to prove everything right. But unfortunately, in this case, you are wrong. It is really going to become morning. Do you want to know another indication? Please come out and look. Erumai siruvidu meivan parandana kaan. Can you see buffaloes going in groups to have their breakfast? Now, it seems that buffaloes are very tough animals to get milk from. It's not easy to milk buffaloes. If you have to milk buffaloes, then you need to give them a special breakfast in the mornings. And what is this breakfast? This breakfast is dew-laden grass. And dew-laden grass is available only early in the morning. So cowherds ensure that buffaloes are given this special breakfast of dew-laden grass in the morning so that they can get their share of milk from the buffalo. So you can see cowherds are taking their buffaloes in groups to give them this special breakfast. Now, this activity of giving buffaloes a special breakfast is called Siruveedu Meyaradu. And this is a very typical term used only by Gopikas and Gopas. Aandaal has specifically put this term in her Thiruppavai just to prove that she's become so much one with the character of the Gopika that she has even forgotten to use normal language and is using the language which is typical of Gopikas. So she's saying, Siruveedu Meivan Parandana Kaan. Purvacharya say that Aandaal was so much into her character, so much into this Bhavana Prakarsham, that her language and even her dress became like that of the Gopikas. Not that she was just dressing up like the Gopikas, but her dress in fact started smelling of ghee and butter like the Gopikas. So much she was involved in her Bhavana Prakarsham. So she's talking about Siruveedu Meyaradu in this Pasuram. Now the girl inside is listening to this episode of Siruveedu Meivan, the episode of Buffalo Breakfast, and she laughs and says that, my dear friends, this time you people have something called Vipareeta Jnanam. Now what is Vipareeta Jnanam? Again this girl is talking some jargon which we don't understand. They ask her to explain and this girl explains nicely again. She says, Vipareeta Jnanam means understanding something which is not at all there. Means what? Means that here there are no buffaloes present at all. You people are all imagining. What? We are imagining? Then what is this which is going as groups? Can you also see from your window? Please see. The girl says, yes, I can see something moving in groups. Something dark which is moving in groups. You know, sometimes darkness itself appears like clouds or bundles. And when the breeze blows, these bundles of darkness seem to be moving along. So that is exactly what's happening. It is just pitch dark. And this darkness and the breeze is giving you an illusion of buffaloes moving around. Actually, there are no buffaloes present, she says. The girls outside are like, oh my God, it is impossible to argue with you. Fine. Let it be. We don't want to argue with you. We only want you to come. The girl inside now says that, okay, you want me to come is all fine, but somehow I feel that the entire population is not yet present. Rather, just about half the population is present. From the noise that I'm able to hear that you people are making, it seems to be me that only half of our group is present here. The girls outside say, you are really intelligent. Your sense of hearing is also superb. You're right. Only half of us are present here. The rest half is already proceeding to the house of Krishna. Mikkulla pillaigalum. The rest of them are on their way. But you know what? We have not let them go. We have made them stop at a point. Povan pogindrarai pogamal kaathu. We have made those girls stop. We have made those girls stop who are so intent on going, you know. These girls are enjoying the yatra of going to Krishna's house so much that they do not want any more experience than that. They are so much into it. Such intentful girls have been stopped by us for your sake. Now, Povan Pogindrarai has a very beautiful meaning. Many a times, the goal is nice and enjoyable, but the path towards the goal is even more enjoyable. For example, we go to Tirupati and have darshan of the Lord. We can hardly see him for a few seconds. But the activity of walking along the Tirumala is really an experience by itself, which is even more worthwhile than taking that few seconds of the darshan of the Lord. So here, the yatra of Tirumala, the path, is even more enjoyable than the actual goal. So also it is said that when Akrura went to meet Krishna, he enjoyed the yatra from Mathura to Vrindavan. Akrura was sent by Kamsa to fetch Krishna from Vrindavan. So he went with the desire of meeting Krishna. So much was his love for Krishna that he kept on thinking about him all along. And as soon as he reached the outskirts of Vrindavan, he started looking at the sand and he found the footprints of Lord Krishna, the footprints which had the marks of the conch in the discus. And he identified them as the footprints of Krishna and he started kneeling down, smelling that sand, taking it and putting it to his eyes and proceeding further, saying that these are my Lord's footprints. So much he enjoyed the way to go to Krishna's house that actually meeting Krishna himself became secondary. So the path became even more enjoyable than the goal in this case. So also for these girls, these Mikkulla Pillaigalum, this path that they are taking is so enjoyable. But we have made them stop that enjoyment also only for your sake. The girl inside is now surprised. She's like, why at all do you want to stop her? Go ahead. No, you also join. Then the girls outside say, how can we do that? You are so important to us. Kodukalamudaya pava yelindirai. You are the most enthusiastic one. Kodukalamudaya pavai. You are the one having kutuhalam, enthusiasm. So your enthusiasm is going to add lot of fervor and vigor to our group. You need to come immediately. Please come. Yelindirai. Let us go and sing his glory. Padi parai kondu mavai pilandane mallarai maattiya. Let us sing the glory of that Lord who slew the mouth of that horse. Ma vai pilandan. Ma means horse. Vai pilandan is the one who opened the mouth of that horse and slew him. Who was that? He was none other than Lord Krishna, Keshava. We saw in the last pasuram. That Lord Krishna's praises we must sing, who did away with the wrestlers. Mallarai maattiya. That Lord Krishna, who is Devadi Deva, Devadi Devanai, Sendrinam Sevital. He is the God above all gods. He is the supreme deity and he has come down for our sake. So we need to go to him. And you know something, if we go to him actually, Sendrinam Sevital, he will be really awestruck. Ava Vendru Araindu Arulelo Rembavai. Why would the Lord be awestruck if we go to him? Because he is the most compassionate one. He will think that despite having so many distractions in this samsara, these girls are coming all the way to me, all the way leaving behind everything that can distract them. They look at me as their goal and me as their interest. So I am so indebted to them. That is the feeling the Lord will have. Ah, wow, Vendru, he will say, it seems. And this is precisely why he is Devadi Deva. You know, he has no ego about himself. That is why he is above all. So let us go and sing about his glory and his praises. And thus get his grace. Arulelo Rembavai. Let us tell him to shed his grace on us and he will do so. listening to this beautiful interpretation of Andaal, this third Gopika comes out and joins the band.